First of all, congratulations. You've made it through 35 years. And strange enough, I still remember day one. Because at that time, we were in the midst worldwide of a tremendous revolution, the atheistic communist revolution. And I was following the track of the revolution through Russia, Siberia, China, Vietnam, Africa, and then into Latin America. So what are we now going to do in Latin America? The signs were all over of imminent danger. And he was a great reservoir of believers, but also a great reservoir of people who all spoke one language. Well, you can say Portuguese or Spanish, but it is a whole continent divided over those two basic languages, really. So we felt we had to do something, but I wasn't there. I didn't know anything about Brazil. But then Dale Keatsman, an eminent linguist, had joined our ranks, and he was actually the first one who gave hands and foot to the base in Brasilia. Dale Keatsman. You remember that name? Dale Keatsman. He's still alive, and I'm still in touch with him. Now you can imagine how old he is. And now then, Elmira, one of the first ones to work with me from the HEF, her son, many other friends. Now 35 years. And that's why I say big congratulations. That's tremendous. I never thought it would last that long, because Brazil was not really started for Latin America. In my mind, the Brazilians with the knowledge of Portuguese, they should go, emphasis on go, to Angola and Mozambique. And that is exactly what I want to tell you now. Because I was reading only yesterday and today that tremendous verse in John 15, you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit. Now, why this verse? It's also my wedding verse. And I always interpreted that as personal for me and my wife, Corrie. That's why I have our picture there at the very page. And I have chosen you that you should go. But then this weekend I was looking it up again in some other translations, and I found that the word you is not in the singular but in the plural. So it doesn't mean just me, it means us, all of us. God has chosen us to go, and that is the great calling upon the base in Brasilia. You did go, and not only to those two countries in Africa, you went to many other countries, and you did a fantastic job. Occasionally we were able to come over and help you, and I remember those visits. Oh, do I ever. One of my visits, I think of my 75th or 70th birthday, you gave me a big black suitcase. Strong, indestructible suitcase. I still have it, actually, after all those years. And I remember the wooden shoe, but then made of chocolate, that you gave me, and I was so proud of it. I kept it until it was not brown anymore, but white, and I couldn't eat it. I'm sorry about that, folks. I remember your coffee, but first of all, I remember your input, your love, your warmth, your faith, the wonderful young people you work with, and now that even Jeff Taylor and others will come to celebrate with you. And I wish I could be there, but this is all I can contribute. Thank you for helping us. Thank you for pressing on, because the battle is not over. It may not be communism now, but something else. But basically, it makes no difference. We have a message, the message of the risen Lord, and we bring it with joy and gladness, and we have a very fruitful field in the country of Brazil, and my heart is all with you, so God bless you real good. Amen.